The year was 1977. While women gathered at the Alice Paul March in Washington, D.C., two ladies gathered in Philadelphia to create their own group dedicated to advancing women. The city would never be the same.
The idea to start the forum came from hearing about a group in New York that had started a similar group.
We said, you know, we probably have enough professional women now in Philadelphia to do something like this and to make it be a really interesting experience for everybody.
Lee and I were starting a business called Distaffers back then that focused on finding professional jobs for women, which was a revolutionary concept.
And what better thing to do for them than to get them all in one room and talk about professional women and to kind of start a club that would be supportive.
And we decided to do it at the Racquet Club because they wouldn't let women be members of the Racquet Club. And my husband was a member, so I made a reservation in his name, I believe. And I never told him this either.
People have to remember that there were no women members of the Racquet Club, the Union League, and probably not the Sunday Breakfast Club and all those things. I mean, there are no women.
Lee and I invited 60 women to come to lunch at the Racquet Club. We realized through the forum that there was a real genuine desire on the part of women to come together and, you know, enjoy each other.
In the early years, the forum was spreading the word about its successful members and taking a closer look at issues facing women in business. It was time to determine what was possible and time for women to connect, to join together to share common experiences, and to start a dialogue about how to leverage their power to advance women in leadership.
We just formed bonds and friendships that, you know, I have them to this day. They're my closest friends, they're the people I want to be with, they're the people that have, I think, helped me, you know, so much in my career.
Think that even if you were the only woman at Smith Kline, or you were the only woman at Provident Bank or Girard, you now had a phone number, you now had a lifeline. You had somebody you could call.
I think this was really the first time, certainly around here, that women came together and realized, you know, that we didn't all have horns and we really could get along and, you know, wow, you know.
I suspect now that there are probably a number of companies that have multiple members in the forum, and some of them may actually compete with one another for promotion, I don't know. But back in the beginning, of course they didn't, because there were so few of us that you were kind of the queen of your castle, if you were, only you weren't. So it was very nice to have friends who were in other companies in similar situations.
It's like we almost went through something together, which the forum was a huge part of it. It was sort of like a safe place to come, and gave us all confidence that somehow, you know, wasn't all that bad and we could make this happen. And in fact, it did happen in Philadelphia. Was a great place for this to all occur.
The forum continued its momentum and, with a leader in place, pursued the issues at hand, including getting women on boards and in the executive suites. Their Women on Boards report became regionally and nationally recognized. With interest in this issue growing nationally, the forum joined forces with like-minded women's leadership groups around the country, co-founding ION. The momentum surrounding this issue had begun and continues to this day.
I joined over 10 years ago because I was looking for a place where I could go, meet with colleagues and peers, and have sort of a network to rely on. And then I found that it was more than that, and that's what's kept me a member for the past 12 years. which is we have like-minded interests that we pursue. We have a give-back mentality with mentoring younger women and with trying to get more women in corporate boards. And we have liaisons with the business community, so there's a lot more to the forum than what I originally joined for. Today, you know, a lot of women work as compared to, I think, back 30, 40 years ago. But women still have some issues. It's still harder for women to reach the top. It's still harder for women to be on corporate boards. Women still aren't paid the same as men. So there's still some disparity and some gap that's left to be addressed. The forum has been working with the City of Philadelphia on the topic of women on boards. And recently we've gotten some interest from both City Council, Councilwoman Blondell, Reynolds Brown, as well as Mayor Nutter on what can the city do to help move the numbers in terms of number of women on boards and number of women in executive positions.
I think the great opportunity for a partnership between the City of Philadelphia and the Forum of Executive Women is using the research and data that the Forum has compiled, using the strength and weight of the city government to put into action what that data shows, which is that there are qualified women, there are positions that should be made available, and we need to raise awareness on both.
Both the publications of the Forum, as well as its programs and initiatives, gained attention and respect throughout the region. Partnerships and alliances formed, allowing even more opportunities for voices to be heard. Today, the Forum celebrates 35 years of trailblazing history and longtime friendships. Glass ceilings have been shattered, but there is still more work to be done.
I think that the biggest expression of success for women in Philadelphia would be to have a women on boards number and a women in executive positions number that was in line with national average.
I'd be happy when women can control their own bodies and their own health care.
More women CEOs, more women in positions of power.
I definitely want to see a woman president.